wow, this is it. This is the beginning of the rest of my life.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad.
Before Janela, I would say yung love life ko parang perpetually on the rocks.
Ang dami naming gusto sabihin, pero walang lumalabas sa bibig namin.
As in, like, sobrang speechless kami. Pero we noticed that we couldn't wipe this smile off our faces, this crazy grin. Hi, I'm Marcus Patterson. I'm the proud father of Jude Trevor Patterson, and sasabihin ko sa inyo, the House of Fatherhood. I grew up sa UK. Doon talaga ako lumaki. I spent my formative years there. Except grade 5 and grade 6. Nung grade 5 ako, lumipat ako dito sa Manila just for a short stint. At ang rason ng nanay ko, kailangan kong makuha yung Philippine culture na kahit papano. So she made me study here in the Philippines for 2 years, grade 5 and grade 6 lang. Pagkatapos nun, bumalik na ako ng UK at nag-aral na ulit ng high school. Growing up, super close kami ng dad ko. Simula nung nag-retire siya, kasi nung working pilot pa siya, he would be away for weeks at a time. Siguro mga 3 to 4 weeks at a time nagtatrabaho siya. Depende kung saan siya nakastation, either Dubai or Hong Kong or minsan Germany din. I would only see him once a month. Pero yung once a month na yun, sobrang sinusulit ko kasi sobrang close namin nung bata ako. Close pa rin kami ngayon. And the same lang naman with my mom. So while my dad was away, siya lang yung nag-aalaga sa akin. Other than my sisters na bumibisita rin minsan. Pero siya yung talagang close ko sa bahay, yung super mom ko. Siguro, sige, sabihin ko na lang na medyo rebellious ako. Pero masunurin din ako kasi yung nanay ko very, very strict. At very physical yung discipline niya yun nung bata ko. Her rules made me the man I am today. Before Janela, I would say yung love life ko parang perpetually on the rocks. Ang gusto ko sa love life ay stability and seriousness. But at the time before Janela, I wanted that. Before I knew myself as a person, para ang dami kong push and pull sa buhay ko na hindi ako sigurado. What made me fall in love with Janela? Siguro parang I answer this question a lot, and I don't think I'm ever gonna change my answer. It's a gut feeling that you get once you meet someone and you connect on a molecular level. Like, you have so many interests that are similar. You have so many things to talk about. Her wholeheartedness, the warmth she is when she speaks to me. I mean, it's a beautiful thing what we have. And to everybody that's out there that's in love right now, I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. It doesn't make sense, really. The moment where she told me we were expecting was... Actually, magkasama kami nun. Nasa Boracay kami. We were enjoying the sun kasi kakagaling lang namin ng UK from the winter, celebrating Christmas with my family. So, for a couple days before the trip, she's been feeling medyo weird na. Pero nung araw na yun, she felt very, very bad. Parang dun na siya nag-open up sa akin. Is it okay if we buy a pregnancy test? So yeah, I was like, of course. Tapos nasa hotel room lang kami, waiting for the results. And then, you know, after a 5 minutes or something, ayun, we found out together, sabay. Ang dami naming gusto sabihin, pero walang lumalabas sa bibig namin. As in, like, sobrang speechless kami. Pero we noticed that we couldn't wipe this smile off our faces, this crazy grin na excitement. That's when we found out, and it's always gonna be memorable, yung hotel room na yan. Of course, nung time na yan, we were thinking about our privacy and of course the healthcare factor of it, dahil of course may COVID na nun. And of course, and I have this thing where I really wanted you to be born in the same hospital I was born in. So natapad naman yun at sobrang saya ko. We were born in the same wing of that hospital. So super memorable, super sentimental. Just being in the house where I grew up, and Janela's already comfortable there also. It was a nice breath of fresh air para sa amin. Our biggest fear about bringing Jude into the world with the surrounding pandemic was obviously the risk
the risk of giving birth because, you know, everything has to be sanitary. So that was my biggest fear. And even the slightest complication, I don't know. That was before these new variants that were coming in. So parang, just the fear, just the risk of any complications during the procedure. Yun lang naman yung siguro fear, the biggest fear. I prepared myself for the role of fatherhood by just becoming a dad. Wala akong tinake na steps, wala akong binasa na being a dad for dummies. Wala. It's a different journey for every father, you know. And I just kind of wanted to learn while doing it with Jude. Because I knew I was going to be with him 24/7 as soon as he was out. And there's no better way to learn how to be a father than just being a father. I just closed my eyes and hope for the best, and it's gone so perfectly so far. So sobrang saya ko. Well, Jude is from one of my favorite Beatles songs, Hey Jude. Also, it means praise. And Trevor is actually my dad's name. My dad's name is George Trevor Patterson. I don't know, it's like a family tradition because my name is Mark Paul Robert, and Robert is my dad's name. So, yeah. So Trevor came from my dad, and Jude is just, you know, a beautiful name. Thinking back to the time, the first time I saw him come out in the delivery room, and the first time I heard his cry, the first time I held him, it was such a strange feeling because it was a feeling that I never felt before. It was beyond ecstasy. It was beyond joy. It was like an elevated sense of accomplishment. Wow, this is it. This is the beginning of the rest of my life, you know? It was the realization that elevated the whole experience for me. The sleep is probably the hardest thing to adjust to while raising a newborn. Still adjusting, but I feel like I'm like 90% adjusted. Pero yun lang siguro, yung tulog lang. Everything else, Jude's been a complete angel. 24 hours with Jude here in Manila would go kind of like this. He wakes up usually at 2 or 3 a.m. for a bottle. So I make him a bottle, feed him a bottle, put him back to sleep around 3:30. He wakes up again around 4 or 5, another bottle. And then he's awake na until siguro mga 9:10. And then he naps again until 12. And at 12, Chinella makes his food, either mashed up broccolis or we boil some potatoes or some avocado. And then after his solids, usually he's not full enough kasi hindi pa siya masyadong sanay sa solid food. So we usually give him another bottle maybe an hour or two later. And then magnanap na naman siya ng 2 p.m. or something. And then that's usually his long afternoon nap, so mga 2 to 4. And then from 4 p.m., gising na siya, we keep him up, we entertain him, we play with him. And then at 7, that's when I give him his bath. And then at around mga 8:30 to 9, that's when he starts getting sleepy. That's when we give him his last bottle to knock him out. And then he's out until the next day, which is again around 2 or 3 a.m. A lot of people are saying he's looking more and more like me ngayon. Pero sobrang kamukha niya yung tatay ni Janella. As in, sobrang kamukha niya ngayon. Kahit yung buhok, yung eyebrows, yung nose and lips are mine, for sure. Pero like every time I look at Jude's face, like dead on, sobrang nakikita ko yung tatay ni Janella. And when I asked Janella, she says she can see my dad. So ang weird. He's at that stage where he's squirming na. He's not crawling yet, but he's learning. So he's just kind of squirming in the bed. And whenever he discovers a new movement, natutuwa siya ng sobra. So, ngingiti siya, tatawa siya ng mag-isa. And sobrang cute lahat ng mga nuances niya na ganun. The last cutest thing that Jude did is everything. Nung nakita ko siya the first time, para talagang may switch sa utak ko na nag... Tapos naging papa mode ako. As in like papa bear, that's it. Like lahat ng priorities ko nag-switch. Na all leading towards him and his well-being. So ngayon, the fact that one day he's not gonna want to hug me. He's not gonna want to be carried by me. He's gonna grow up and that sucks. Kung pwede siya maging baby forever. I'm torn kasi gusto ko siya... I want him to grow up and I want to play football with him. Pero at the same time, gusto kong baby na lang siya forever also. So parang ang hirap din. It's just the fact that one day, pipiliin niya yung mga kaibigan niya kaysa sa akin. That's what scares me. Kasi baka mamaya magpikon ako. Magselos ako. I don't know. I keep saying this. It sounds cliche. It sounds very movie-like. Pero gusto ko lang maging masaya si Jude. No? Kahit he can be anything in this world. He can be a window cleaner. He can be a fan maker. He can make electric fans and I would still be happy. Basta may ngiti siya pag-uwi niya sa bahay. And I don't want him to be forced into a, you know, a career or whatever he wants to do without him wanting to do it. So, yeah, in the simplicity of it, yung dream ko para kay Jude is maging masaya and to love us for it. We all rise together. We all, you know, we build this family on the foundations of love, trust, truth, and honesty. Happiness is a hard thing to find in this day and age. So, yun lang naman talaga ang importante para sa akin, maging masaya ang buong pamilya ko. My dreams for myself as a father, siguro, it's hard eh. It's a hard thing to think about for myself because at this point in time, it feels like all of my dreams have come true. I mean, yung dream ko na lang siguro na to have better sleep soon. In a nutshell, yun na lang siguro. Yun na lang sabihin natin. Hey Jude, if you're watching this, it's your Papa Bear. I love you to the stars and back, and I hope you're not crying right now. I just want to thank you because you have made me a better man by 100 times. And you have given me a reason and motivation to live and do what I love. And in 20 years, if you're watching this, I hope you're living in a huge mansion that I funded because I'm going to work extra hard just for you, Bubba. All right, love you. Take care.